ಎರಡನೇ ಭಾಷಣಕಾರರು ಈಗಿನ ಜನರೇಷನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಜ್ಯೋತಿಷ್ಯ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರದಲ್ಲಿ ಇಷ್ಟೊಂದು ಆಸಕ್ತಿಯಿಂದ ಅದನ್ನು ಅಭ್ಯಾಸ ಮಾಡಿರೋದು ತುಂಬ ವಿರಳ. ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಉತ್ತಮ ಉದಾಹರಣೆ ಸುಪ್ರಜಾರಾಮ ಅವರು. ಈಗ ಸುಪ್ರಜಾರಾಮ ಅವರು ಮಾತಾಡ್ತಾರೆ.
ಸೊ ಐ ಆಮ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡೂ ಅ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಅವೇರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಟ್ ಶ್ಲೋಕ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ರಿಸೈಟ್ ದಟ್. ವಿಲ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದಟ್ ಆಸ್ ಅನ್ ಆಪರ್ಚುನಿಟಿ ಟು ಫೈಂಡ್ ಟೌನ್. ವೈಲ್ ಹಿ ಡಸ್ ದಟ್ ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಡೂ ಅ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ದಟ್ಸ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಇಟ್ಸ್ ನಮ ಸೂರ್ಯಾಯ. ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿಟ್ ಡೌನ್, ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸಿಟ್ ಡೌನ್, ಇಟ್ಸ್ ಓಕೆ. ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕೀಪ್ ಯುವರ್ ಹ್ಯಾಂಡ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸ್ಪ್ಡ್. ದಟ್ಸ್ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ನಮ ಸೂರ್ಯಾಯ, ಚಂದ್ರಾಯ, ಮಂಗಳಾಯ, ಶನೇಭ್ಯಶ್ಚ, ರಾಹವೇ ಕೇತುವೇ ನಮಃ. ಸೊ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಕಾನ್ಫರೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಜ್ಯೋತಿಷ. ಸೊ ಇಟ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅಸ್ ಟು ಸ್ಟಾರ್ಟ್ ವಿತ್ ದ ಪ್ರೇಯರ್ ಟು ದ ನವಗ್ರಹಸ್. ಕೆನ್ ಯು ಆಲ್ ಸೇ ದಿಸ್? Is this visible? Okay. So how to judge a horoscope? Now they have given me a very difficult task of speaking for about 45 minutes to 1 hour on a subject I myself took close to about. Can you hear me? So they have given me a very tough subject, how to judge a horoscope, and they have given me only 45 minutes, though I am also one of the key trustees of the Raman and Rajeshwari Research Foundations. Looks like my voice was not heard, and
they have given you 1 hour, so you can comfortably speak.
But I started my learning of astrology when I was just 4 years. So at that point of time, they just made me mechanically by heart a lot of things. So I started by hearting Sarvartha Chintamani, Bruhat Jataka, Parashara Hora Shastra. I started mechanically by hearting without knowing the meaning of what these slokas were. And slowly over a period of them, then they started introducing me to astrology, later on concepts of astrology. Today I've just finished 38, so I'm nearing 39 years now. So I have learned astrology for 35 years now. So it took me 35 years to understand how astrology in its beginning works. So doing justice in 1 hour will not be possible. Having said that, I didn't want you to go back empty-handed. So today what I will do is, I will give you a very innovative method in which you can increase the accuracy of your predictions. Okay, does that sound like a good subject to speak on? Yes? Alright, excellent. Now broadly we understand astrology. I'll give you a little bit of background to it. Let me spend about a minute. Broadly we understand astrology in a particular manner. First and foremost, we call this three stride approach to astrology. So in order to really analyze a horoscope, so there are three approaches. Now astrology is not just horoscope. Astrology is beyond horoscope. There is Muhurta, there is Prashna Shastra, there are a few other peripheral aspects as well. Today I'll focus only on horoscope because the topic is how to judge a horoscope. Now in order to understand how we go ahead and analyze a horoscope, we broadly follow three important steps or three strides. That would be the most relevant word. First and foremost, what we do is we understand how the environment around us behaves. For example, today we are all part of this astrological conference, right? This is not in your control or my control. It was actually in the control of the great institution MES College and also the Raman and Rajeshwari Research Foundation. So that's not something that we have control in. So we need to understand how the environment behaves or reacts in a particular point of time. The next thing that we have to look at is, in a given environment, how do we react to that environment? That's the next stage of astrology. And the third one that we talk about is, when the environment and when the human being, they come together in a union, what would be the outcome of this? So that is the three stages of astrology. Now first and second stage have been extensively covered by Parashara, Mantreshwara, Vaidyanatha Dikshita, Jayamuni, that's why Jayamuni Shastra, that's what we say, right? A lot of people have covered it. So wrongly some people say this is Parashara system, this is Jayamuni system and all. It's all one integrated system. The third leg, where is the fusion of the environment and the individual, is covered extensively in nadis. unfortunately, these nadis that we have, they have not given us how to understand them. They have given us only the outcome. So, if you look at Shuka nadi, Bhrigu nadi, one is the Graha based nadi, one is the Rushi based nadi, the other one is concept based nadi. So, there are many different types of nadis. So, totally, there are 6 different types of nadis that we are aware of today. If we have to, there are 108 known nadis and probably another 100 and 150 unknown nadis. But broadly, whichever nadis that we have today, we can broadly classify them as 6 nadis. In all the 6 nadis, except for certain ones like Deva Keralam or Shuka nadi, etc., most of it only outcome is given. They do not tell us how to arrive at that outcome. So that's the drawback in nadi. So what I will do is I will give you a methodology in which you can start arriving at the outcome. Fair enough? Does that sound like an interesting proposition today? The proposition is called ASTROZAP.